and that they were all, you know, independent small businesses that didn't have the power to have like, yeah, big websites and marketing budgets. And what if I was able to build a platform that kind of gave them a place to transact, a marketplace? So I rang Alex back. I really don't think she followed the thread of the conversation about a year had passed. But I was like, forget the virtual school of music. How about if we formed the Amazon of local services? At the time, that was the best comparison I could do. There was no Uber, there was no Airbnb. They were to come a few years later. And she's like, yeah, maybe there might be something in that once I explained it. But I didn't know where to start. Literally, my only kind of vision of entrepreneurship was Dragon's Den. That was about it. And that seemed kind of scary. So luckily, though, a couple of friends of mine in London were kind of able to put me down the right path. And throughout this journey, you get moments of luck kind of coming in. And one of that was that a good friend of mine, Dr. Bob, he's a computer science lecturer at Imperial. And he said, Jules, you're a nerd. You did maths at university and stuff. You could learn enough coding to build a terrible prototype that will never really see the light of day, but will kind of at least show people what you're thinking here. Like, you could do that. And he pointed me in the direction of this book, Ruby on Rails Tutorial. I bought it in hardback, so I couldn't copy and paste. I had to go through from cover to cover. And it took you from installing the software to ultimately building a clone of Twitter. It just looked like, it kind of acted like Twitter did. And when I did that, just evenings and weekends, still working at PwC, and I started changing the button. Instead of like, post a tweet, it was like, look for a driving instructor or, you know, whatever. And I started taking shape a little bit more to this website idea that I had thought. And I found myself doing it in every minute that I had spare at work. You know, I was like typing away and then I'd be like stealing a glance at the coding book. And I thought, well, there's something here. So it looked a bit like this. And then this was actually, I would love to say this was the first version, but it wasn't. This is probably after about a year of me trying to do this. It was called Teddle at the time, which is after my dog Ted, because I could get the domain name for like £6. Right around the same time, this book came out. It was called The Lean Startup by a guy called Eric Ries. So I'd read the book and he was coming around doing a book tour and doing Q&A and stuff. And I dragged Alex along. So I was on career break. She was still very firmly employed at Accenture, thinking I was mad. And I brought her along one January night to this book launch. And it turned out that the sponsors for it were a team called Springboard. And Springboard was running a startup accelerator. And they would select 10 or 12 of them to go through this intensive program at Google's building in central London. And against their better nature, they chose us. It was a baptism of fire. You got introduced to hundreds of mentors and angel investors and entrepreneurs, and they poked and prodded and pulled your idea in every which way. But at least we now had a product out there. It was something that was like real. We had released it to the public, and so many ideas only ever live inside our heads. They never get anywhere. And we never even get the validation of, does this work, does it not? And so that in itself was great. The vast majority of people coming to the website were looking for cleaners. And we didn't have very many cleaners. Kind of felt like a bit of a problem. And we thought, well, what about if we just rebuild the website and just focus on doing one thing and doing that great, rather than 27 things kind of mediocrely. We pitched her on. And he saw something in what we were doing, and he looked at like kind of even on those really small numbers, he kind of saw the metrics and how things were going. He's like, this is interesting. And so he helped round up a group of investors to basically close out the rest of that £250,000. Well, you got three paths: die, which no one wants to do, float, or exit. Like, they're your three options, really. And you know, we might have had some very long term aspirations for floating, but we were nowhere close to that. That wasn't a viable alternative. So when someone wants to acquire you, you have to really consider it. We made that decision and we ended up selling the company in July of 2015. So, you know, for me, 5 years kind of from start to finish, but really very compressed from when we decided to do cleaning only, raising that first round, second round, acquiring companies and whatnot. It all kind of felt like, yeah, warp speed. And one of the big things for us was that what they'd seen in us was the technology that we built. So that book that I had bought that had started, you know, like, you know, with me installing some software and building Twitter was what we sold, and what they ended up moving the 15 countries that they were live into onto like our platform. And I think if anybody in the room are thinking and you have that idea and you're wondering that you're going to regret it, you know, if you can and if it's right for you, try it on like the smallest risky, like least risky basis possible and iterate from there. And if you get positive feedback, iterate again and see where it goes. And, you know, there was no good reason to think that when I bought that book, we'd end up where we did. But it didn't happen overnight. It was just one step in front of the other. Anyway, that is the story of how I spent my last 8 years.